want to look at now tithe.
Olero tugenda kutunulira ekimu ekyekumi.
We want to come up out of the broad perspective of giving.
Twagala tuve ku mutwe guli omunene ogw'okuwa gwe tubaddeko.
Now let us look at. We have heard people talking about tithe. And sometimes we have misused it. And sometimes we have over exalted it. And sometimes we thought it's magic. So let us critically look at this important topic. I love what John Maxwell says.
Jagalanyo John Max Chagamba.
That seek understanding to avoid misunderstanding. But also, I love what Prophet Hosea says. Prophet Hosea says, my people perish for lack of knowledge. If we are to paraphrase that sentence, we can say that people will error at the point of their lack of knowledge. Now, first of all, let's ask ourselves these major questions. Turn to your friend and say, let us ask ourselves these major questions. Amen.
Amen.
When we ask ourselves major questions, we will give ourselves major answers. Amen, church.
Amen.
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 Now, what is a tithe? What is a tithe? Number one, if you have a pen, you can write. A tithe is a tenth of everything you get. Actually, we are commanded to give tithe on everything. But we have become too commercialized that we think tithe is only money. Well, seasons have changed. Israel, a tithe meant on everything. It was a law in
Israel
that if you are harvesting cucumber, you would pick 1, 2, 3, then the tenth one you'd put it aside. A shepherd would stand at the door of his sheep pen, and then he would begin to count under his rod every animal that went out. 1, 2, 3, 4. The tenth would say, that one is for the Lord. But right now, this is a commercial economy. Those were agricultural economy. Secondly, a tithe, the Bible calls it holy unto the Lord. Now, these are the names the Bible calls the tithe. Number one, it's a tenth of everything. It is holy unto the Lord. It belongs to God. It doesn't belong to you. Now that's a tithe. That's a tithe. Amen.
Amina.
Why do we give a tithe? What is a tenth? I have explained it. Now another major question. Why do I give a tithe? In other words, why does God command me to give a tithe? Are you with me, church? Oh yeah. You know what? We need to know. The Bible says, go and make them my disciples. Now, how do someone turn into a disciple? A disciple of Jesus? Jesus said, go and make them disciples by by teaching.
Yesu nagamba nti mugende mubanfulira abayigirizwa bange nga muyita mukubasomesa.
Not preaching.
Si kubulira.
Not exciting.
Si kubachamusa.
There is a time for preaching, there is a time for exciting, there is a time for prophesying.
Wali wakasera ko kusomesa, wali wakasera ko kuchamusa abantu, wali wakasera ko kuwa obunabbi.
But when time comes for grounding someone so that he may know why he is doing something in the kingdom, Jesus says, teach. 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 What am I doing here? I am teaching. There is enough anointing to teach. And this anointing of teaching, when is present, it destroys the powers of darkness that shields your mind. It opens the mind. It opens the spiritual eyes. And then you get a sigh of relief. Oh, okay,
no
time I understand. Give God a mighty hand clap. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In the house of the Lord. Now why do I give a tithe? Number one. Because God commanded it. Let's read in Malachi chapter 3 and verse
10.
Now this is what the Bible says in Malachi. If I may read from this translation, which is called NCV. Let's read together on the God does not beg here. He's commanding. Bring to the storehouse a full tenth.
Mulete ekitundu ekyekumi ekiramba.
Of what you earn, so there may be food in my house. Now you test me in this, says the Lord all-powerful, and I will open the windows of heaven for you and pour out all blessings you need.
Mulete ekitundu ekyekumi ekiramba mu ggwanika, ennyumba yange ebeeremu emmere, era munkeme nakyo, bwayogera Mukama w'eggye.
Now listen here.
Wuliriza wano.
Bring into the storehouse a full tenth.
Mulete ekimu ekyekumi ekiramba mu nyumba ya Mukama.
It is so, you know, a tenth.
Ekimu ekyekumi.
I mean, sorry, a tithe is a tenth of everything.
10,000
shilling, a tithe of it is 1,000. 100,000, a tenth of it is 10,000. Now, it is so easy to give a tithe when you are still getting
10,000.
Now, why God says bring a full tithe? Because when we are faithful with little, God entrusts you with much. Now, when you come into much, that's where a tithe begins to deviate from being full to quarter to half. I'm telling you the truth right now. Some of you, it's so easy to give a tithe because you are getting 10,000. You are getting 1,000. And 1,000 is so easy to give 100 shillings. God will shift you from 10,000 to 100,000. And you'll be required to give a tenth of 10,000. And when you are faithful, he will shift you. And he will take you into a million. A season will come. Now when your earning is one million. And you are required to give a tenth of 100,000. And then God will shift you from 1 million now to 10 million. And you'll be required to give a tithe of one million. If you are faithful there, God opens doors and windows of heaven and into your mind, and he will begin to give you ideas that can attract 50 millions. He gives you ideas and minds and dreams. And when he gives you those dreams, he gives you the power even to fulfill and to make wealth. That now you are able to get 50 millions.
100
millions. And your tithe will be 10 millions. Now, that's where people begin to swerve. They begin to swing. And they say, God, I think you know.
But
anyway, even I give 5 million. After all, it's a lot. This is where God is saying to the nation of Israel, bring the full tithe and test me. Because the more people get money, the more needs and demands. That's why they begin to debate whether they should give a full or a half. And that's why God is testing them. That I know you have 100 million. You're supposed to give 10 million. And yet according to your needs and your businesses, you need 150 million. Now you are debating whether you should subtract even from their 100. Now this is why God says, you test me. Don't rely on what you have. Trust me. You test me. You give it full. And give me the opportunity to prove to you that I, who brought you from getting 10,000 up to where you are, it is I who will take you even where you think you want to go. Hallelujah!
Amen!
Do I give a tithe? Because God commanded it. Amen.
Amen.
Now, number two. Because God demanded
it.
God commanded it. Secondly, he demands. Leviticus 27 from verse 30 to 33. Hallelujah to the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Leviticus 27:30. We can look here in NCV. Says, now, ladies and gentlemen, if you can listen clearly these words, your lives will never be the same. You know, we have 7 levels of listening. I will not go into that. One day I'll come and teach you on these 7 levels. And that's why there is always a difference between people. You find same people, same background, same church, but after some time, different results. Because of levels of perceiving. I'll talk about that time. One tenth of all crops belongs to the Lord. Now, God is commanding.
Katonda wanalagira.
I mean, he is demanding it.
Wanachisaba.
He's telling Moses
Agamba Musa
to tell the Israelites
okugamba abana ba Israeli
anything of which is a tenth.
Nti ekintu chonanga chimucha kumi.
Please never use it.
Tochikoze sanga.
That is for me.
Echo change.
It's for my work.
Echo chamiri mujange.
It's for my house.
Chanyumba yange.
Do not
togeza.
Including the crops from the fields and the fruits from the trees.
Erebi tundu byo nebye kumye byensi obanga byansigo zansi obanga byabibala muti byamukama biba bitukuva eri mukama.
If a person wants to get back that tenth, one fifth must be at that one fifth, that is 20% of its value, must be added its price.
Era omuntu wana yagalanga okununula ku kitundu kye. Kujitundu vya eje kumi, anagatanga ko echitundu chavyo, echokutano.
In other words,
mungeri endala,
I have a tithe.
Ninechimwe eche kumi.
But I have a pressing need.
Na hini neche tago.
And I said, Lord,
nengamba mkama,
I will use it.
Ngenda ko sechimwe eche kumi.
But I will bring it back.
Nengenda kuchiza.
God says,
mkama agamba,
no problem.
Tewali buzibu.
If you choose to do that,
na yewa osala wako lecho,
add on a fifth.
Gata ke echimwe eche okutano.
To its value.
Kumuendogo.
Bring it back to me. Now, you know, Israel was an agricultural society. All their economy depended on agriculture. Our economy right now, these are just words written in. Our economy is both cash and agriculture economy. Amen?
Amen.
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 So why do we give a tithe? But God demands it.
Era kubanga chetaga.
Number 3.
Echo kusatu.
Where should I take my tithe?
Echimwe cha 10 change nchitwalawa.
Now we have heard so many ideas and fine words.
Endowooza nyingi n'ebigambo bingi ebyogera.
And fine arguments.
Era nga abantu abamu bakikayanamu.
You know what? When I was coming,
we never denzija.
I got my tithe. I saw someone in need. I gave him my tithe. After all, it's God's money. Look at me. If I kept you with my money, can you say someone came by and was in need and you say, after all, Pastor, this was your money, so I decided to give it to somebody else.
Let me say, if you are the one, you've kept your money with someone, and he says, this money, you say, keep for me this money, and then on Tuesday you bring it to me, I know what I'll do with it. Can you come and say that when I was coming,
I
found someone in need of money and I gave it to him. Can you do that? Or when I was coming, I saw a good camera. And I said, after all, it's your money. Maybe you need this camera. Why do you think for the owner of the money to use it to do something?
Hallelujah!
Amen.
Hosea says,
Hosea gamba.
Let's read it, Hosea 4:6. My people are destroyed from lack of knowledge. Because you have rejected knowledge, I also reject you as my priests. Because you have ignored the law of your God, I also will ignore your children.
Abantu bange bazikiridde olw'okubulwa okumanya. Kubanga oganye okumanya, nange ndi kugaana gwe. Olemenga okubeera kabona gendi.
My people, what destroys them?
Chichi echizikiriza abantu bange.
Is lack of knowledge.
Kubura kumanya.
Now in this era,
mumulembe guno.
You know, in those days,
munakwezo mubire ebyo.
People did not have the Bibles.
Abantu tebayina Bible zino.
The scrolls were only read by the Levites.
Emizingo gino gye bayina byasomebwanga Balevi.
So people did not have access to the full information.
Abantu nga tebayina bubaka butufu.
So that's why Hosea comes out and says, what is destroying my people? They have no access to information. They have no access to the knowledge of what I want them to do. If Hosea is right now in this age, he would say, my people perish for disobedience. Gamba amina yempaka.
Amen.
Amen. Blessed.
Gamba mpere do mukisa.
I am blessed.
Mpere do mukisa.
I am blessed.
Mpere do mukisa.
In the name of Jesus.
Mulinya lya Yesu.
I am blessed.
Mpere do mukisa.
Because
kubanga
I have
nina
full knowledge.
Okumanya.
Where should I take my tithe?
Mweche kumichange nchitwala wa.
I don't take my tithe to where I want.
Sichitwala yonze jempulira jenjagala.
I don't take my tithe and give it to some, to the people I think that maybe it's appropriate to, for God. I don't take my tithe and I see someone preaching on TV and I say, after all, it's all God's money. Now, so that you make
sense. Main.
You know, this is why people are going to hell. The devil lies them. After all, you can go to heaven through any other way. You can go to heaven even when you go through this religion. Yet the Bible is clear. It says, I am the way. Period. Period. The way is not in
Buddha.
Is not in religion.
Dini.
Is not in Mary.
Or Maria.
Is not in Joseph.
Yosefu.
Is not Yuda Tadeo.
Yuda
is not Muhammadi.
Muhammadi.
Is not Krishna.
Si Krishna.
The way
Ekubo
to heaven is in Jesus.
Yesu.
Either you believe it or not.
Obaneda.
So it's the same thing when it comes to tithe. I don't do what I think. I do what God has laid down. God commanded the tithe. Then when you are about to give it, go back and ask, Lord, what directives did you lay down? And he will tell you. Now let me show you the directives he put there. Amen.
Amina.
Give God a mighty hand clap.
Deuteronomy
12 from verse 5 to 6. Where do I take my tithe? Not on TV preaching. Not because I went in the lunch hour. Not because today you came and pray from here. I was preaching like this one day. It so happened where I stay. There is one lady was called Nakato. She was our neighbor. And she got a tithe. And she came to my house to be prayed for. But I wasn't there. And she met Barbara. And then when I came back, Barbara came and said, Mchara Nakato wanted to see you because wanted you to pray for the tithe. So I said, okay, please tell her on Friday I'll be around. So on Friday she came. And she brought a full tithe. Now when I was about to pray for her, I asked her, do you pray from our church? Because I thought maybe since people are many in the second service, maybe you cannot know.
And
she said no. Then I asked her, where do you pray from? And she told me, is it churches called Hope and Revival?
Hope and Revival.
I asked her, where is it found at that time? I did not know where it was. And she described the area.
How
I told her, you get this tithe. Yes, you learnt it. One day you visited our church, you learnt it. But you take it to the pastor. It's your pastor to pray for this. Because that's what the Bible says. Very good, she did so. After some years, the lady shifted. And she started residing over this side. She made this her church. And I was teaching again about tithing. And I said, where do you take the tithe? And at that moment, I remembered that now Nakato is in the congregation. What if I had not done what was according to the word?
Do you see?
Kirungi nnyo ogoberanga ekigambo kya Katonda.
It is always good to follow the word of God.
Tekikyuka.
It doesn't change.
Nga bwe namala okisomesa nawulire essanyu ne ngamba nti kale omukyalo ono weyaleetera ssente zonna ezo singa nazitwala.
After teaching, I was so glad because I thought, what if I had taken that money?
Nandibadde mulimba mu maaso
ge. I would have been a liar before.
Nandibadde agambye iyi naye ate nga nze bwe nazireeta teyazikkiriza.
She would have said, but by the time I brought it to him, he received it.
Mulaba abasumba.
Do you see those pastors? Pastor, it's so good to move according to the word.
Lineage leaders.
Contrary to the word. Don't do anything that is contrary to the word.
Because one day someone may come and speak it.
Then
one of the people in the congregation will remember that you did that in a different way. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Give God a mighty hand. Okay. Now, where do I take my tithe? But you are to seek. The word seek means make sure you find that place. You are to seek the place the Lord your God will choose. Now, these are people who are still in the wilderness. From among all your tribes to put his name there for his dwelling. Now, look at this. To seek the place and the dwelling. In other words, wherever people are, God chooses a place and puts there a dwelling. A dwelling means a house, a building. In that building where we come and worship. In other words, where God takes you to worship, which becomes your spiritual family, there take your tithe. Verse 6. There in that place, bring your burnt offerings, bring your sacrifices, bring your tithes and other special gifts.
In the
place of worship, where you go to worship, which is your church, your spiritual family, God wants you to identify your spiritual family. Yes, you can go and visit. You can go and visit other churches. But you are supposed to have a church. You are supposed to have a home. A people who know you. Who can recommend you. From the place where you will catch the anointing. I can visit uncle, auntie, jaja, whatever, but I must have a home. Now, God said, your offerings, your sacrifices, your tithe, and special gifts, and what you have vowed to give, and even your free will offerings, and even your firstborn herds of flocks, which is first fruit. All those categories of giving bring them to that place.
Katonda gamba nti ebyokera byamwe sadaka zamwe n'ebitundu byamwe byeku n'ekiwawayo kisituliwo eky'omukono gwamwe n'obweyamo bwamwe n'ebyo byemuwaayo ku bwamwe n'ebibereberye by'ente zamwe n'endiga zamwe byonna mubiretenga mu nyumba ya Mukama.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Give God a mighty hand clap.
Kubira Katonda mungaleza amanyi.
Verse 10 and 11. Verse 10 and 11. But you will cross the Jordan and settle in that land the Lord your God is giving you as an inheritance. And you will give and he will give you rest from all your enemies around so that you
can live.
Then to that place the Lord your God will choose as a dwelling for his name. There you are to bring everything I command you. Burnt offerings, your sacrifices, your tithe, your special gifts, and all choice possessions you have vowed.
Amen.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
Say amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Gama chai mukama.
Say Lord.
Ntegede.
I know.
Kubanga mchifocho wano.
For in your place here.
Munyumba wano.
In your house.
Wenareta ngeimwe bie kumi.
I'll bring my tithe.
Echiwe buwayo.
My offering.
Sadaka.
My sacrifice.
Nobwe ya mu.
And my vows.
Nebira bobi yange.
And all my gifts.
Najanga nembuwele zanga wano.
I'll come and serve from here.
Osoboro kumpo mkisa.
So that you bless me.
Nobu gaga.
And give me wealth. Katukubira
ko Yesu Kristo mungaro.
Now give Jesus a hand of praise.
Do
you know what is amazing?
Ngo ori outside those principles.
Now it is hard for you to prosper as long as you're outside those
because
principles.
God cannot prosper you when you don't know.
Kubanga Katonda tasobola kukulakula nyanga tomanyi.
If he prospers you when you do not know where you belong, where you're supposed to give what to do, you become wild and
bwakula kulanyanga tomanyi chicho inakola tomanyi wawo inatwala chimu cha 10 obela woboto botyo.
God is a God of order among his people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's what Paul told Timothy. Sorry. No, the Corinthians. He said, listen, Corinthians. God is not a God of disorder. He's a God of order among his people. And it's so amazing that I find born again churches when they are so disorganized. They don't know what to do. This one stays there, the other one goes
inside.
Another one steps on the pulpit, another one comes to give a testimony and he sings.
Is
that a God of disorder? And that's why even the Bafere have come in and they have decided
that is why con men batandika okufera abalokole
because they are using the same giving
because bakozesa okuwayo kwe kumu.
They talk about giving. We have seen what a tithe is. Why do I give it? Where should I give it? Now let me ask, what is the purpose of the tie in the house of God? Sometimes all we do is to give a tithe. But why did God command it? And when it comes to the house, what specifically does it do? Still, God revealed all things here. Give God a mighty hand clap. Number one, Deuteronomy will tell us
14:26-29.
What is the purpose? You know, I love God. Whenever he commands something, he goes ahead and describes the purpose for which he has. The silver to buy whatever you like. Cattle, sheep, wine, and other fermented drinks, or anything you wish. Then you and your household shall eat there in the presence of the Lord your God and rejoice. God is saying to the children of Israel,
Katonda gamba n'abaana ba Isirayiri.
I'm going to bless you.
Ngenda bawa omukisa.
Use silver, gold to buy anything you want.
Okwegulira byonna bye mwetaaga.
And especially when you are going to the house of the Lord.
Okusingira ddala nga mugenda mu nyumba ya Mukama.
And sometimes buy and eat from there. You go with your family and eat in the presence of the Lord. God in the Old Testament commanded people to come and eat from the temple courts.
Verse 27.
Do not neglect the Levite living in your towns, for they have no allotment or inheritance of their own.
No mulevi ali munda wenzigi zo tomwabuliranga kubanga talina mugabo ne wankwado busika wamu nawe.
Now Levites is a tribe that it was a clan or a lineage from Levi.
Chali chika cha Levi.
And God came and said, I choose the lineage of Levi.
Era katonaja nagama nti nelondedde chika cha Levi.
To serve me.
Okumperezanga.
In my temple courts.
Muwembu yekalu.
I will not give them allotment.
Sigenda kuba wa mugabo gwonna.
Other lineages.
Ebikebirala byonna.
Other clans,
like the
lineage of Judah,
Manasseh,
Ephraim,
Ephraim,
all those I have given them an inheritance. From this place, Judah, from this place, whatever. I have given you land. Till the land and crop and the crops. Raise the ship. Trade.
Musubule.
But the Levites command you to do in Israel. In other words, you have no land. You have no possession. You have nothing. Why?
Because
you are serving me. You look at me. It will be me to bless you. Otherwise, if I give you land, if I give you possession,
you'll
be too busy with your affairs. You will neglect my work. That was the principle. Gamma Tamina.
Say amen.
Now God is telling Israel, as I have blessed you, use your silver to buy anything you want, to drink, to eat, buy houses. But remember what I have told you about the Levites. They have no allotment. They have no inheritance. I never gave them allotment. And I never gave them an inheritance. So I am their inheritance. Amen.
Amen.
Let's go ahead. Verse what? So at the end of every 3 years, bring all the tithe of that year's produce and store it. At the end, so that the Levites who have no allotment, inheritance of their own, and the aliens, the fatherless, the widows who live in your towns may come and eat and be satisfied, so that the Lord your God may bless you in all the work of your hands.
No mulevi kubanga taina mugabo ne wankubado busika wamu nawe ne munagwanga ne mulekwa ne namwandu abali munda wenzigizo bana janga ne balya ne bakuta mukama katonda wo aliyoka kuwo mukisa mu mirimu jonna.
Amen.
Amen.
Let me give you another scripture. Numbers 18:20-21. The purpose of the tithe is to meet the needs of the Levites. People who work from morning to evening in the house of God. I'm going to show you a demonstration here in just in a few minutes. The Lord, now look here. The Lord said to Aaron, you will have no inheritance. Aaron is the father of the...
Aaron, ye tata wa bakabona.
Amen.
Amen.
Now God comes to Aaron and say, Aaron will have no inheritance in their land, that is in Israel.
Najeri Aaron inamugamba nti no Aaron itobenga na busika mu nsi yabwe.
No will you have any share among them. I am your share and I am your inheritance among the Israelites.
Satobenga na mugabo gwo namubo nze mugabo gwo no busika bwo mubana ba Israeli.
Gama chamina yempaka.
Say amen.
God is telling Aaron.
Katonda gamba Aroni.
And your descendants.
Naba muvamu.
All those who are priests.
Abobo nabo nanga ba.
You.
Bakabona.
In other words, God is speaking to Aaron and the priests.
Aloni, na
you have no allotment. You have no inheritance. I am.
Verse 21.
I give to the Levites all the tithes in Israel as their inheritance in return for the work they while serving at the king.
Era bana balevi labamba wadde ekitundu byo ebitundu byo nebye 10 ebyo mu Isirayiri okuba obusika okubempera yokuwereza kwabwe kobawereza kuwereza okwo muwema eyokusisinkanirangamu.
Siro wadde busika.
I've not given them an inheritance.
Siro wadde mugabo.
I haven't given him any allotment.
Mukama nalagira Isirayiri.
But God commanded Israel.
Muletenge imwe bye 10 byonna.
To always bring the full
mu nyumba yange.
In my house.
Bwamalo kiragira.
And after commanding it,
nalyoka chuka.
He turned around.
Naja eri Aroni.
And he came to Aaron.
Kabona omukuru.
The chief priest.
Nagamba uliriza Aroni.
And he told him, listen to me, Aaron.
Sibo wade mugabo.
I've given you no allotment.
Sibo wade busika.
I've given you no inheritance.
Mba wade omugabo gwange.
But I've given you my allotment.
Ebimu bye 10 byonna.
All the tithes.
Abana ba Isirayiri be baleta.
The children of Israel will bring.
Kati mbikute.
I've got them. And when they give them to me, now I give them to you. That is your allotment.
Gamba mine yempaka.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ogwo gwe mugabo gwabwe olwo kumpereza okuva kumacha paka lwagula paka chiro ngabali muyekalu yange olwo kansolinga olwo kuchalira olwo kusabira olwo kusomesa olwo kuteka teka no kumanya biro nabiri nabyo no.
That is what I've given you for all the work that you do in my house, say counseling my people, preaching,
so,
and preparing everything.
Aroni, Aaron,
whenever the tithes come,
know
all the Levites around.
Return the work they do while serving at the tent of
meeting. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Woo,
we go. Verse 23. It is the Levites who are to do the work at the tent of meeting and bear the responsibility for offenses against it. This is a lasting ordinance for the generations to come. Awula kagamba ako. Ekigambo kino kyendagidde kino kikwata bwe kiti. China kolebwanga waddenge endagaano enkadde weddewo ne tuyingira ne mu mpya.
That this word has to be followed even if the Old Testament ceases and we go into the New Testament.
They will receive no inheritance among Israel. Verse 20. Instead, I give to the Levites. I give the Levites as their inheritance, the tithes, not the offerings, not the vows, not the sacrifices, not the pledges, but I give them the tithe. Judah, Ephraim, Manasseh, blah blah blah, Ephraim, whatever. Ebidako. Issachar, Dan, and so on. Ati mukama na agamati.
God said.
Gwe Aaron.
That Aaron.
Echike chimu chinecha Aaron.
This one tribe.
Mwe sigenda bawa busika.
I'm giving you inheritance.
Na ye chikacha Judah mba wado busika.
But unto the tribe of Judah I'm giving
you
an inheritance.
Wali pako gende yo,
from the other river to the other side, that is your land.
Mwemba wada masala nitaga Isra ye
takaliamu. I'm giving you the other
na mwemba wade takaliamu.
I'm also giving you land.
Mutako mo mulimeko. Tako mo mulimu feza nezabu.
There is silver and gold in the land.
Mulimu yoga gebilala, mulimu diamond, mulimu chi.
Many other riches.
Kutakali okuli kama futa.
On your land there is oil.
Kutakali mwemkuli kwa omusenyu.
Yours has sun.
Oguzimbi buwa no kukula. kukola magirasi
used for making glasses
kutakala mwekulike ebumba erikola amasowani agebumba
yours has mud making
ara kuliko osobola okulimira noku nokufikirira
plates you can farm
now mukama naga mabwate
now God said
kati mumazo gagawala
now that you're rich
mukose feza nezabu okugoye mwagala
use silver and gold to buy what you want
mubiretenga mulirenga ne maso gage
bring them and eat before me
naye mmwe ndane bikabya mumujukirenga abalevi
but you and your tribes always remember the levites
mujukire ekika kya abalevi
remember the tribe of levi
kanolwecho munde chemba malagira okuva lero kubulike mukola chonna
from today henceforth from whatever you do
mumpeke chimwe che 10
give me a tithe
echimwe che 10 change
that tenth is mine
tochitwa lajo yagala
don't take it where you desire
tochigaba woroza
don't take it where you think
kirete munyumba yawe
always bring it to my house
nawe
you and you and you and you
bwamalo balagira bwati
and after commanding them like that
kati mukama jeri aaron
now the lord came to aaron
namgamba aaron
and said aaron
wali wonga andagira abana ba isaili bono kumpe chimwe che 10
you were here when I commanded all the israelites to give me the tithe
eimwe bya 10 byange
the tithe is mine
na ye wo mulimu gwe munkolera
but because of the work you do for me
mbiba wadde
I give it to you
we
you
na bale ekika kya balevi bonna
the entire levite clan
gama chamine yempaka
say amen
na
kati
lwachi mukama yagashi mucha 10 bwati
why did god say that the tithe
labeno bali bameka 10 1 2 3 9 singona ite chimwe che 10
ngame she brings her tithe
omutwalo
let's say 10000
omutwalo
10000
omutwalo
10000
bulomo mutwalo
everyone 10000
bulomo ina kuwa ke chimwe che 10 meka
how many has anyone got to give
chimucha 10 zwa meka lubaru 10 secho
1000
bweruboru 10 tugambe kuliko mulalo omuwano
let's say there is another 10th person
tuli 10 secho
10
bweneto ru 10 bulomo asero 10 ziba sente meka
everyone brings 1000 how much is it
netuguwa mu nyumba ya mukama eri abachi
and then we give it to the levites
abalevi amen
amen
now olaka ndabo ali fair
you see how fair god is
wafunya mutwaro
you got 10000
mutwaro nange mutwaro
and me 10000
twete imwe byafe bye 10
when we bring our offerings our tithes
tusigaza meka fe
how much do we remain
bulumasigaza meka
how much
ono tumuwa de meka
how much have we given
mutwaro
10000
mukama tali fair yao
you say god is not
atabana bona bona basigaza kenda
yet all the other ones have remained with 9000
bayeto mutwaro
when they bring the 10000
no
this person
mukama amugamba
god tells him
katu we chimwe che 10
now give me your tithe
na yasigaza meka
also remains with
kenda
9000
kama amine yempaka
say amen
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 kakati wano mukama wayogerera
now this is when god says
bwetu ono bwagano kweto olukumi
if this person refuses to bring the 1000
oh no
and say the other one
oh for example kati afunye afuna milioni 10
or let's say she earns 100 million
milioni 10
me 100 million
milioni 10
100 million
ono nagamba andowoza nsobola okuwako mukama amugamba atya
and the other one says maybe I can give
let her chimwe che 10 ekijuvu
bring the full tithe
amira
main
mu nyumba yange
in my house
mwemwe nebika mulete
all of you tribes bring
kubanga atune chike chiri muyekaru
nakachika the tribe in the temple is a tribe
muisrayeli abalevi bavire misiri bali almost emitwaro abiri
by the time the israelites left egypt the levites were like 20000
amen
amen
now abantu bano bolere chimucha 10
when these people don't bring the tithe
chechino mukama chayogerako
this is what god says
namucha aliwa utamufayo Malachi
In Malachi
so what happens when we do not honor what god commanded
chachi tabawe to start samuchitiwa mukama chealagira
god calls you a robber
katonda kuita munyasi
Malachi chapter 3 verse 8
Malachi 3:8
Malachi chapter 3 let's begin with verse 8
katandika ku
now god begins to speak
katonda tadi ko kuogera
it so happened that the tribes of israel stopped bringing tithe or sometimes they used to bring it in an awkward way
tuketsera bana bayise ne balekerawo kuleta imwe bya 10 oba mu ngeri etali ntufu
now god spoke sent prophet malachi
katona natuma nabbi malachi
and malachi said to prophesy
malachi natandika okulagula
this is what the lord says
basi wayogera mukama
will do you think
will
a man rob god
omuntu alinyaga katonda
do you think you can rob me
olowoza sabolo okunyaga
do you think you are smart enough
olowoza olimugeze chimala
do you think you can take what belongs to me
olowoza yiza twale che change
Gworoza ndo soro kunyaga.
Do you think you can rob me?
Orokuwa manuvalinze bwoti nokola bwoti ne bwoti.
You've done this and that the other way.
Nokula kula ne bwoti ne bwoti.
And then you prospered anyway.
Bwena kulagira okumpe chimweche 10.
When I commanded you to give my tithe.
No chitwala.
And you took it.
Noga matoile chokoze chibi.
And you said you've not sinned.
Osubiro yinzo kunyaga.
Do you think you can rob me?
Agwembulira.
Tell me.
Simanyi wosula.
Don't I know where you
Simanyi wotambula.
Don't I know your ways?
Simanyi planizo.
Don't I know your plans?
Oyinzo kunyaga.
Can you rob me?
Gworoza ngo yinzo kunziba.
Is that what you think that you can rob me?
But you ask, how do we rob you?
Nayene mwebuza tukunyaze tutya.
You have robbed me in my tithes and offerings.
Nagamba munyaze mu bimwe bya 10 nebiwewayo byange.
Now next Sunday I'll be teaching you the work of a tithe. The work of an offering.
Wechiwewayo.
Now this time around God is saying, you have robbed my tithe which is supposed to be for the
Katonda agamba munyaze chimwe che 10 change chino kubere cha balevi.
Amen.
Amina.
But you have robbed it.
Na yemwe muchinyaze.
Then verse 9.
Oromwenda.
You are under a curse, the whole nation of you, because you are robbing me.
Mukoli midre chikoli mwecho kubanga munyaganze egwanga inoryo na.
Now here God is not saying I have cursed you.
Wano katonda tagama ntimba koli midde. No.
He's saying
agamba
you have put yourself in the position of a curse.
Ntimwe mweta de for HH Kolimo.
Because if you disobey me,
kubanga we mutangondera,
then you are obeying something else.
Muba mwinech dala chemugondera.
You are obeying your intuition, your knowledge, your thinking.
Muba mugondera okulowoza kwa mwo kumanya kwa mwina magezi gamwe.
Which cannot stand the attacks of Satan.
Ebita sawala kuyimirira ngo mulaba abalumbie.
So in other words,
mungeri endala,
your disobedience,
obujamu bwamwe,
you are robbers.
Mwe abanyazi.
Not only of become robbers, you have positioned yourselves in the line of a curse. And then he goes on saying, verse 10, now you bring that whole tithe into the house so that there may be food in my house. You test me in this, says the Lord Almighty, and see if I will not throw open the floodgates of heaven and pour out so much blessing that you will not have room enough for it.
Kiramba mugwanika enyumba yange eberemu emmere era munkeme nakyo bwayogera mukama wejje obanga siri bagulira ebituli ebyomuggulu ne mbafukira omukisa ne wataba na banga weguja.
When you bring my tithe, I'll prevent the pests from devouring your crops and vines in your field. I will not cast their fruit, says the Lord.
Era ndi nenyomuli kulamwe so talizikiriza bibala byattaka lyammwe so n'omuzabibu gwammwe teguli kunkumula bibala byagwo mu nnimiro
oyagadde okunziba.
You wanted to rob me.
Ebibala entandika okunogokera mu nnimiro.
And then your vines have started losing their fruits.
Olowoozza okunziba.
You thought of stealing me.
Obuuka gye buvudde ne buli ebimera byammwe.
And then all the pests have come and devoured your crops.
Agamba gwedda kati muli mukunoonya pesticide gweddamu muli mukunoonya mbuddagala ly'okufuuyira na biki. Gwekola bukozi kye nkugambye olabe nga sidde eno ndyoke nenye ekintu ekibadde kirya.
He says that instead of looking for pesticides, just do what I've commanded.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mukama natero okunenya katebadde biririra ebintu byamwe gama tamine
yakaka. God is yet to rebuke the devourer and all the pests. Say amen.
Mukama kuwa mukisa wa mma. Somesiza bulungi. God bless you my young girl. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Agamba gwereto labe.
He says taste me in this.
Nga sinenye obuhuko obukulirira.
See if I will not rebuke the devourer.
When I gave you my 10,000.
When I gave you my 10,000.
Ne kugamba mpaka 10,000.
And I said give me 1,000.
Waruganira.
You withheld it.
Choka mukuruganira.
And withholding it.
Obuka bwajja ne bubulya.
Pests came and destroyed it.
Obuko bwendwadde.
Say diseases.
Obuko bwa accident.
Say accidents.
Obuko bwesente okugwa.
Say losing the money literally.
Obuka obwentalo.
Say wrangles.
Obuko bwa kufirizibwa.
Say losses.
Agamba wegeza akola be.
Says test.
Mukama yebazibwa. So agamba bwona akikola.
He says that when you do it.
Nze ngenda kugulirawo enziji.
I'll open up doors for you.
Mukama yebazibwa.
Nay.
Wadde tusomesa bwetu ti.
Though this is how we teach.
Kati oweza kuja nobuuza nti pastor, ekimwe kumi kyonna bwe kijja.
You may
abalevi bakirya.
Pastor, when the tithe comes, do you distribute it to the Levites in this church?
Kati nkulaga engeri ebintu gye byayina okubeera.
I'm showing you how things had to be.
Nayo olw'obujeemu n'okakanyavu bw'emitima gyaffe.
But because of this obedience,
singa mbuuza
mufe
batono abawa ekimu eky'ekumi.
Even if I ask a few of us give the tithe.
Ate ekirala
and
abamu tukoma kuwa kimu kyako.
Some of us just give only the tithe.
Tetuwa chiwebwayo.
We don't give the offering.
Kati ngenda kubulira omugaso gwo chiwebwayo next Sunday.
Now next Sunday I will tell you the purpose of the offering.
Kati buli chiwebwayo bwe kitajja.
Now whenever the offering doesn't come.
Tithe nejja tingalayo mu bitundu.
And the tithe comes in bits.
Kati we sanganga fa abalevi.
So with the Levites.
Atafe tugera ntukwata tewe tukutaje ntuteeka mu kanisa.
We get what we have and then we invest into the church.
Aine tulioka tuongerako ne tukatukola emirimo.
And then we do the work.
Kati bambi nolyo kola bango omukisa gwo nate gubera ku
That is why the Levites now get blessed in return. No
sanga atenze mwabade bayino kuwaba omukisenyo kubanga mu reality mwe muino kugagawale nyo okunsinga.
In reality you have to be rich more than
Gamba chamina.
Say amen.
Munono zobwa katonda.
According to godly principles
mwe mulino gagawale nyo.
You must be more wealthy.
Okusinga bakabona.
More than the priests.
Enonogwestambula
nayo
olwokubanti ebintu byachu
but because of disobedience and the changing of things and ignorance
kati mukama anonya omuntu wokozesa
God is looking for someone to use
amuyise mu sentezo
to be a channel to
zisobola okujaziyamba obwakabaka
bwe in order to expand his kingdom
ensonga lwaki mukama ayagala bayisa mu
sentezo the reason as why God wants you to be channels
enyumba yeberemu ebikozesebwa
is that his house might have things
omulimo gwe guberemu emirimo
that
omulimo gwe gubeka ebintu ebikozesebwa
That things might be done in his work.
Amen.
Main.
For example, tuli mu perimeter wall.
For example, we now building the perimeter wall.
Perimeter wall we nagwa walwe mlume jigendo kulwa wejo bwa katonda.
After the perimeter work is the perimeter wall is done.
Abantu bagenda ku meeting irangawo.
People will be meeting from that place.
31st bagenda kusabirangawo.
On 31st people will be praying from
there. Functions jena kulirangawo.
We shall have functions over.
Lineages muzigenda kubera.
Some lineages will be meeting out.
Echo kubiri.
Secondly,
abantu bala bobugabirizibwa akatonda.
People will see the provision of God.
Mukama yagala for example tukola olugudo olongala chorus mukama agulumizibwa.
For example when we made this road chorus God was glorified.
Nebo bomuzimbe kanisa nga yabwempe bitu na bijja.
But when you build a church.
Bagamba katonda wabwaliwa.
Like where is your God?
Lwaki mumuletera okunyomebwa?
Then why do you let your God be shamed and despised?
Kati basebo ne banyabo.
So ladies and gentlemen.
Katonda yagala obere omwesigwa mu kitono.
God wants you to be faithful in little.
Akufuna omwesigwa mu kinene.
So that he may make you faithful. Bero
omwesigwa mu kimwe kye 10.
Be faithful in your
Nebuwe bwayo
and your offering
alioka kugaziye
sabari meyenna
ekisera kituuse
a time has come
kama wabana wajira ku mitwaro 10 jo badofuna
God will take you off from that 10,000
akutwale ku milioni
100,000 to a million
akuje ku milioni
from a million
ekisera kituuse
a time has come
okwate ku milioni 2
for you to earn 20 million
ekisera kituuse
a time has come
okwate ku milioni 2
for you to live 20 million
okwate ku milioni 2
and get to earn
ekyo kyenda ba
that is where
no wezi mukazi gwe musajja gwe
Ori
mu milioni 10
You're in 100 million
Ne milioni
2 And 200
Musajja gwe mukazi gwe
You man and woman
Kisoboka
It is possible
Nkirabyeko Wano mu kanisa
Nina
wabantu
The people
Bemba denda ba
I've been watching
Bentunulide
I've looked at them
Okumala emyaka
For years
Nga batandikira mu mutwaro
They started with 10,000
Nga bali mu mizigo
In rent
Kati nga we bali
Now
Bazimbe zi mansion
They have mansions
Naje na gamba musumba
They say pastor
ngojeke ebirala byonna
Besides everything else
Esende zensiga za obusigazanga ezo sina chengenda zikozesa
The money that I just keep when
I've got millions 15 ezo millions 15 kwa sina gamba school fees zaziliko
emoto
kale ziliko simanyi bichite biliko
No nothing
kale zensiga ziza
Just my money to keep
nga nokuwa mazoku wa buli chimitu
na chini After giving everything
sigaza millions 2
I keep like 20 million
sigaza millions 3
I keep 30
Abamu wanita nebo account naga nalekera ku savinga sente zange mu shilling kati ni savinga mu dollars
Some of them say that I no longer save my money in shilling
Hallelujah
Amen
Nali nchirabye
have seen it.
Ngabali babadde wano.
They've been here.
Batundanga nobuntu sono kuwa testimony.
They used to sell certain things and they can even testify.
Abamu baba banzikiriza ni mukogera nabo basobola kuvayo bajibawe ku bujulizi bwa.
Some of them
mubajiba baba wo bujulizi.
Can come and testify.
Ekisera kituse mukazi gwe musajja gwe.
The time has come, you woman and man.
Oba ku 15,000.
To live 5,000.
Ezo nzibogorera mu nyara Yesu Kristo.
I back at that in the name of Jesus.
Kumitwalo 10.
To live 100,000.
Yes, mubori mitubobobobongo chali mu myaka 2 is fine.
Fine if you're 20, it's okay.
Ezo kola nyo.
Work hard.
Bera yoi oigobu kakamu.
Know how to be humble.
Gendo okolo mulimo gwonna gw'osobola okola.
Go and do any kind of job you can do.
Neka rutuse mu myaka 3 nokuda.
But if you're in 30s and above.
Sita kusubira kuwanga ufuno omwezi mitwale 5.
I no longer expect you to get 50,000.
Amafuta agali mu kifo kino.
The anointing in this place.
Teka kukiriza.
Can't allow you.
Teka kukiriza narongo.
It doesn't allow you.
Secho narongo.
Isn't it?
Narongo yaliwo obujulizi bwena yo nakuru.
She will testify to you.
Teka kukiriza amafuta ago.
Can't allow you.
Amafuta esawa zino.
The anointing here.
Yakuragira.
Commands you.
Ndio twaliwa mu bifebye enja uno.
To be taken to higher places.
Emoto kazimezi zo.
Cars.
Amayumba gaberega go.
Houses will be yours.
Mungezise mubino murabe.
Test me in this and see.
Mukama yabazi.
Amen.
Kalichovola bakatonda.
That is why God.
Adide nanunya nagamati aliwo omwesigwa.
Abato
nabaliwo besigwa Yesu imbalabye ne ate.
Is that faithful?
Ne ate munange enyumba yange nakoleta nega anti kale kambulessing e pastor habati
ne mampo. And then he says let me bless the pastor.
Naba ne sendi za abantu 15.
And then he has money for 50 people.
Buchandi bade. Naba nga yawelira abana kumpya 12.
Is he the one who's supposed to take care of all those children?
Nasa sulira abantu akumayumba.
To pay house rent for people?
Sibo chibino.
Is supposed to be that way?
Sibo chino kuba.
It's not like that.
Amen.
May.
Oh kubira Yesu Kristo mungano.
Now clap for Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Katowairo mbasomeseza.